This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The Treaty of Brest-Litovsk was a peace treaty signed on 3 March 1918 between the new Bolshevik government of Soviet Russia and the Central Powers Germany, Austria-Hungary, Bulgaria, and the Ottoman Empire, that ended Russia's participation in World War I. The treaty was signed at Brest-Litovsk Polish, Brzesk-Litevsky, since 1945 Brest. After 2 months of negotiations, the treaty was forced on the Bolshevik government by the threat of further advances by German and Austrian forces. According to the treaty, Soviet Russia defaulted on all of Imperial Russia's commitments to the Triple Entente alliance in the treaty. Bolshevik Russia ceded the Baltic states to Germany. They were meant to become German vassal states under German princelings. Russia also ceded its province of Kars Oblast in the South Caucasus to the Ottoman Empire and recognized the independence of Ukraine. Furthermore, Russia agreed to pay 6 billion German gold marks in reparations. Historian Spencer Tucker says the German General Staff had formulated extraordinarily harsh terms that shocked even the German negotiator. Congress Poland was not mentioned in the treaty, as Germans refused to recognize the existence of any Polish representatives, which in turn led to Polish protests when Germans later complained that the Treaty of Versailles of 1919 was too harsh on them. The Allies and historians favorable to the Allies responded that it was more benign than Brest-Litovsk. The treaty was effectively terminated in November 1918, when Germany surrendered to the Allies. However, in the meantime, it did provide some relief to the Bolsheviks, already fighting the Russian Civil War, by the renouncement of Russia's claims on Poland, Finland, Estonia, Latvia, Belarus, Ukraine and Lithuania. Contents 1. Background 2. Peace negotiations 3. Resumed hostilities 4. Terms 41. Signing 42. Territorial cessions in Eastern Europe 43. Transfer of territory to Ottoman Empire 44. Russian-German financial agreement of August 1918 5. Lasting effects 6. Other information 7. See also 8. References 9. Further reading 10. External links. Background. Main articles, Eastern Front World War I and Russian Revolution. By 1917, Germany and Imperial Russia were stuck in a stalemate on the Eastern Front of World War I. At the time, the Russian economy nearly collapsed under the strain of the war effort. The large numbers of war casualties and persistent food shortages in the major urban centers brought about civil unrest, known as the February Revolution, that forced Tsar Nicholas II to abdicate the Russian Provisional Government that replaced the Tsar initially presided by Prince Georgi Lvov, later by Alexander Kerensky, decided to continue the war on the Entente side. Foreign Minister Pavel Milikov sent the Entente powers a telegram, known as Milikov Note, affirming them that the Provisional Government would continue the war with the same war aims that Imperial Russia did. The pro-war Provisional Government was opposed by the self-proclaimed Petrograd Soviet of Workers' and Soldiers' Deputies, dominated by leftist parties. Its Order No. 1 called for an overriding mandate to soldier committees rather than army officers. The Soviets started to form its own paramilitary power, the Red Guards. In March 1917, the position of the Provisional Government led the Germans to offer support to the Russian opposition, the Communist Party Bolsheviks in particular, who were proponents of Russia's withdrawal from the war. In April 1917, Germany allowed Bolshevik leader Vladimir Lenin to return to Russia from his exile in Switzerland and offered him financial help upon his arrival in Petrograd. Lenin proclaimed his April Theses, which included a call for turning all political power over to workers' and soldiers' Soviets' councils and an immediate withdrawal of Russia from the war. Throughout 1917, Bolsheviks spread defeatist and revolutionary propaganda, called for the overthrow of the Provisional Government and an end to the war following the disastrous failure of the Kerensky Offensive. Discipline in the Russian army deteriorated completely. Soldiers would disobey orders, often under the influence of Bolshevik agitation, and allowed soldiers' committees to take control of their units after deposing the officers. Russian and German soldiers occasionally left their positions and fraternized. The defeat and ongoing hardships of war led to anti-government riots in Petrograd headed by the Bolsheviks. The July Days of 1917. Several months later, on 7 November, the 25th of October, old style, Red Guards seized the Winter Palace and arrested the Provisional Government in what is known as the October Revolution, the newly established Soviet government decided to end Russia's participation in the war with Germany and its allies on 26 October 1917. Vladimir Lenin signed the Decree on Peace, which was approved by the Second Congress of the Soviet of Workers, Soldiers, and Peasants' Deputies. The decree called upon all the belligerent nations and their governments to start immediate negotiations for peace and proposed an immediate withdrawal of Russia from World War I. Leon Trotsky was appointed Commissar of Foreign Affairs in the new Bolshevik government in preparation for peace talks with the representatives of the German government and the representatives of the other Central Powers. Leon Trotsky appointed his good friend, Adolf Joffe, to represent the Bolsheviks at the peace conference peace negotiations. Lev Kamenev arrives at Brest-Litovsk. Trotsky greeted by German officers. Special edition of the Lübeckischen Anzeigen, headline, Peace with Ukraine. On 15 December 1917, an armistice between Soviet Russia and the Central Powers was concluded and fighting stopped on 22 December. Peace negotiations began at Brest-Litovsk. Germany was represented officially by Foreign Secretary Richard von Kuhlmann, but the most important German figure was General Max Hoffmann, Chief of Staff of the German armies on the Eastern Front. Oberkommando Ostfront. Austria was represented by Foreign Minister Count Ottokar Czernin, and the Ottomans by Talat Pasha. All these men were conservatives from monarchical countries. The German representatives had effective control of the Central Power side. The Russian representatives were all radicals and supporters of world revolution. They were led by Adolf Joffe, a veteran Red agitator, and included Anastasia Bizinko, who had assassinated a high imperial official. At the start of the negotiations, the two sides were far apart. German plans for Eastern Europe included annexing most of Russian Poland, with Austria to receive a smaller piece. A rump Polish state would be established to act as a buffer between Germany and Russia. In addition, Ukraine would be detached as an independent state under German protection, while the Baltic states were to be annexed directly into Germany and ruled by German princes. For their part, the Bolsheviks declared that they sought a peace without any indemnities or territorial concessions on the 28th of December. The Central Powers delegation withdrew from the conference to consider the Bolshevik peace proposals over Christmas of 1917. The Central Powers released a declaration stating that they were in favor of the separate peace with all the Allies without indemnities and without annexations, provided the peace was immediate and all belligerents took part in the negotiations, but this did not supersede the demand for the independence of Poland and Lithuania. Reassurances from the German side that Berlin wished only for a peaceful, equitable resolution to the conflict met with an angry reply from Joffe. Then why do you wish to tear 18 provinces from us? Lenin was in favor of signing the agreement immediately. He thought that only an immediate peace would allow the young Bolshevik government to consolidate power in Russia. However, he was virtually alone in this opinion among the Bolsheviks on the Central Committee. For the second round of negotiations, Trotsky replaced Joffe as the head of the Soviet delegation. Meanwhile, Count Czernin announced that if negotiations between Berlin and Petrograd failed, then Austria would seek a separate peace with the latter. Kuhlmann then told the ambassador that such an action would result in Germany withdrawing all its divisions from the Austrian frontier, which promptly led Czernin to drop that offer. He also asked General Hindenburg exactly why he sought the annexation of the Baltic states and was told, to secure my left flank for when the next war happens. On 8 January 1918, U.S. President Woodrow Wilson proclaimed his 14 points, which were centered around the concept of national self-determination. The Bolsheviks had long espoused the right of national peoples to self-determination as a part of the anti-imperialist struggle, while Lenin wanted to accept the German peace proposal immediately. A majority of the Bolshevik Central Committee disagreed. The left communists, led by Nikolai Bukharin and Karl Radek, believed that Germany, Austria, Turkey, and Bulgaria were all on the verge of revolution. They wanted to continue the war while awaiting revolutions in those countries. Thus the Soviet delegation returned to the peace conference without instructions to sign the proposed treaty. Kuhlmann and Hoffmann now proposed independence for the Baltic states, Poland, and Ukraine. In accordance with the Soviets' own national self-determination doctrine, indeed, the Germans were already negotiating with a separatist government in Ukraine on 9 February 1918. Germany recognized that government and signed a treaty with it. The first Treaty of Brest-Litovsk, frustrated with continued German demands for cessions of territory, Trotsky on 10 February announced a new policy. Russia unilaterally declared an end of hostilities against the Central Powers, and Russia withdrew from peace negotiations with the Central Powers, a position summed up as no war, no peace. Other Bolshevik leaders denounced Trotsky for exceeding his instructions and exposing Soviet Russia to the threat of invasion. Trotsky subsequently defended his action on the grounds that the Bolshevik leaders had originally entered the peace talks in the hope of exposing their enemies' territorial ambitions and rousing the workers of Central Europe to revolution in defense of Russia's new workers' state. Resumed hostilities. The consequences for the Bolsheviks were worse than what they had feared. In December, the Central Powers repudiated the armistice on the 18th of February 1918, and in the next fortnight seized most of Ukraine, Belarus, and the Baltic countries in Operation Faustschlag through the ice of the Baltic Sea. A German fleet approached the Gulf of Finland and Russia's capital Petrograd. Despite strikes and demonstrations the month before in protest against economic hardship, the workers of Germany failed to rise up against their government. On the 23rd of February, the Central Powers sent new terms for peace. These terms included cession of Dunaburg, Livonia, and Estonia to Germany, cession of Western Armenia to the Ottoman Empire, recognition of an independent Ukraine, immediate evacuation of Russian troops from Finland and Ukraine, and complete demobilization of the Russian army. Additionally, the Central Powers required that these terms be agreed to within 48 hours. Lenin again pressed for acceptance of these terms. This time a majority of the Central Committee supported Lenin. The Soviet government sent a new delegation headed by Georgi Chicherin and Lev Karakhan, with instructions to accept the proposal. On 3 March Chicherin signed the treaty. Thus the new Soviet government agreed to terms worse than those they had previously rejected. Terms: signing of armistice between Russia and Germany, signing borders drawn up in Brest-Litovsk. The Treaty of Brest-Litovsk was signed on the 3rd of March 1918. The signatories were Bolshevik Russia, signed by Grigory Yakovlovich Sokolnikov on the one side, and the German Empire, Austria-Hungary, Bulgaria, and Ottoman Empire on the other. The treaty marked Russia's final withdrawal from World War I as an enemy of her co-signatories, on unexpectedly humiliating terms. In all, the treaty took away territory that included a quarter of the population and industry of the former Russian Empire and nine-tenths of its coal mines. Territorial cessions in Eastern Europe. Russia renounced all territorial claims in Finland, which it had already acknowledged, Baltic states Estonia, Latvia and Lithuania, Belarus, and Ukraine. The territory of the Kingdom of Poland was not mentioned in the treaty. The treaty stated that Germany and Austria-Hungary intend to determine the future fate of these territories in agreement with their populations. Most of these territories were in effect ceded to Germany, which intended to have them become economic and political dependencies. The many ethnic German residents Volksdeutsch would be the ruling elite. New monarchies were created in Lithuania and the United Baltic Duchy, which comprised the modern countries of Latvia and Estonia. The German aristocrats Wilhelm Karl, Duke of Jurek in Lithuania, and Adolf Friedrich, Duke of Mecklenburg-Schwerin in the United Baltic Duchy, were appointed as rulers. This plan was detailed by German Colonel General Erich Ludendorff, who wrote, "German prestige demands that we should hold a strong protecting hand, not only over German citizens, but over all Germans." The occupation of Western Russia ultimately proved a costly blunder for Berlin, as over 1 million German troops lay sprawled out from Poland nearly to the Caspian Sea, all idle and depriving Germany of badly needed manpower in France. The hopes of utilizing Ukraine's grain and coal proved abortive, and in addition, the local population became increasingly upset at the occupying army revolts, and guerrilla warfare began breaking out all over the occupied zone. Many of them inspired by Bolshevik agents. German troops had to intervene in Finland to put down an attempted Bolshevik coup, and Ludendorff became increasingly paranoid about his troops being affected by propaganda emanating from Moscow. This was one of the reasons he was reluctant to transfer divisions to the Western Front. The attempt at establishing an independent Ukrainian state under German guidance was unsuccessful as well. Despite all this, Ludendorff completely ruled out the idea of marching on Moscow and Petrograd to remove the Bolshevik government from power. Germany transferred hundreds of thousands of veteran troops to the Western Front for the 1918 spring offensive, which shocked the Allies badly, but ultimately failed. Some Germans later blamed the occupation for significantly weakening the spring offensive. Transfer of territory to Ottoman Empire. Three Bones, A Bountiful Tip, a political cartoon from 1918 by American cartoonist E. A. Bushnell. At the insistence of Talat Pasha, the treaty declared that the territory Russia took from the Ottoman Empire in the Russo-Turkish War 1877-1878, specifically Ardahan, Kars, and Batumi, were to be returned at the time of the treaty. This territory was under the effective control of Armenian and Georgian forces. Paragraph 3 of Article 4 of the treaty states that the districts of Erdian, Kars, and Batum will likewise and without delay be cleared of Russian troops. Russia will not interfere in the reorganization of the national national and international relations of these districts, but leave it to the population of these districts to carry out this reorganization in agreement with the neighboring states, especially with the Ottoman Empire-Russian-German Financial Agreement of August 1918 in the wake of Russian repudiation of Tsarist bonds, nationalization of foreign-owned property and confiscation of foreign assets. Russia and Germany signed an additional agreement on 27 August 1918. Russia agreed to pay 6 billion marks in compensation to German interests for their losses lasting affects Poland. The Treaty of Brest-Litovsk lasted only 8.5 months. Germany renounced the treaty and broke diplomatic relations with Soviet Russia on 5 November 1918. The Ottoman Empire broke the treaty after just 2 months by invading the newly created First Republic of Armenia in May 1918 in the armistice of 11 November 1918 that ended World War I. One of the first conditions was the complete abrogation of the Brest-Litovsk Treaty following the German capitulation. The Bolshevik legislature VTSIK annulled the treaty on 13 November 1918, and the text of the VTSIK decision was printed in Pravda newspaper the next day. In the year after the armistice, the German army withdrew its occupying forces from the lands gained in Brest-Litovsk, leaving behind a power vacuum that various forces subsequently attempted to fill in the Treaty of Rapallo. Concluded in April 1922, Germany accepted the treaty's nullification, and the two powers agreed to abandon all war-related territorial and financial claims against each other. The Treaty of Brest-Litovsk marked a significant contraction of the territory controlled by the Bolsheviks or that they could lay claim to as effective successors of the Russian Empire, while the independence of Finland and Poland was already accepted by them in principle. The loss of Ukraine and the Baltics created, from the Bolshevik perspective, dangerous bases of anti-Bolshevik military activity in the subsequent Russian Civil War 1918-1922. Indeed, many Russian nationalists and some revolutionaries were furious at the Bolsheviks' acceptance of the treaty and joined forces to fight them. Non-Russians who inhabited the lands lost by Bolshevik Russia in the treaty saw the changes as an opportunity to set up independent states not under Bolshevik rule. Immediately after the signing of the treaty, Lenin moved the Soviet Russian government from Petrograd to Moscow. The fate of the region, and the location of the eventual western border of the Soviet Union, was settled in violent and chaotic struggles over the course of the next 3.5 years. The Polish-Soviet War was particularly bitter. It ended with the Treaty of Riga in 1921, although most of Ukraine fell under Bolshevik control and eventually became one of the constituent republics of the Soviet Union. Poland and the Baltic states emerged as independent countries. This state of affairs lasted until 1939 as a consequence of the Molotov-Ribbentrop Pact. The Soviet Union advanced its borders westward by invading Poland in September 1939 and Finland in November 1939 and annexing the Baltic states, Eastern Poland and Bessarabia in 1940. It thus overturned almost all the territorial losses incurred at Brest-Litovsk, except for the main part of Finland, Western Congress Poland, and Western Armenia for the Western Allies. The terms that Germany imposed on Russia were interpreted as a warning of what to expect if Germany and the other Central Powers won the war between Brest-Litovsk and the point when the German military situation in the West became dire. Some officials in the German government and high command began to favor offering more lenient terms to the Allies in exchange for their recognition of German gains in the East. Citation needed. Russia's post-1991 western border bears a marked similarity to that imposed by the Brest-Litovsk Treaty. Other information. Emil Orlik, the Viennese secessionist artist, attended the conference. At the invitation of Richard von Kuhlmann, he drew portraits of all the participants, along with a series of smaller caricatures. These were gathered together into a book, Brest-Litovsk, a copy of which was given to each of the participants. See also World War I Portal Commissions of the Danube River. History of Belarus. Mitylorofa Treaty of Brest-Litovsk, 9 February 1918, signed by Ukraine. Treaty of Bucharest 1918. References. Carat. Ukrainian. To whom did Brest belong in 1918? Argument among Ukraine, Belarus, and Germany. Ukraininska Pravda, 25 March 2011. Carat. A History of the Habsburg Empire, 1526-1918, by Robert A. Kahn. Page 479-480. Carat. Spencer C. Tucker. 2005. World War I. ABC. Cleo P. Carat. Ruth Fisher, Stalin and German Communism, p. 38. Carat. John Keegan, The First World War. New York, Vintage Books, 2000, p. 342. Carat. Shirer, The Rise and Fall of the Third Reich, 1960, p. 57. Carat. Ludendorff, Erich von. 1920. The General Staff and Its Problems. London, p. Map of Europe after the Treaty of Brest-Litovsk, at Omniatlascom VE World War I Treaties during the War Sykes Pickett Street Jean de Maurienne French Armenian Damascus Protocol London Brest-Litovsk Ukraine Batum Paris Peace Conference Versailles Saint-Germain and Les Neuilly-sur-Seine. Trianon Sèvres Aftermath Rapallo 1920 Tartu 1920 Warsaw Riga 1920 Sawaki Alexandropol Moscow Riga 1921 Tartu 1921 Cilicia Ankara Kars Lausanne Rapallo 1922 Territories of the former Austro-Hungarian Monarchy. Italian reparation payments Sino-German peace treaty Montreux regime of the Turkish Straits abolition of the capitulations in Egypt British Egypt Denmark Greece Norway Sweden Portugal see also, 14 points partitioning of the Ottoman Empire VE World War I home fronts theaters. European Balkans Western Front Eastern Front Italian Front Middle Eastern Gallipoli Sinai and Palestine Caucasus Persia Mesopotamia South Arabia African Southwest East Cameroon Togoland North. Asian and Pacific Tsingtao German New Guinea and Samoa at Sea North Atlantic U-Boat Campaign Mediterranean North Sea Baltic Indian, Pacific. People Entente Powers China French Empire Belgium British Empire Greece Italy Japan Montenegro Portugal Romania Russia Russian Empire Russian Republic Serbia United States Central Powers. Germany Austria Hungary Ottoman Empire Bulgaria Timeline Pre-war conflicts Scramble for Africa 1880-1914 Russo-Japanese War 1905 First Moroccan Tangier Crisis 1905-06 Agadir Crisis 1911 Italo-Turkish War 1911-12 French Conquest of Morocco 1911-12 First Balkan War 1912-13 Second Balkan War 1913 Prelude Origins Sarajevo Assassination Anti-Serb Riots in Sarajevo July Crisis Autumn 1914 Battle of the Frontiers Battle of CER First Battle of the Marne Siege of Tsingtao Battle of Tannenberg Battle of Galicia Battle of the Masurian Lakes Battle of Kolubara Battle of Sarakamish Race to the Sea First Battle of Ypres 1915 Second Battle of the Masurian Lakes Second Battle of Ypres Battle of Gallipoli Second Battle of Artois Battles of the Isonzo Great Retreat Second Battle of Champagne Kosovo Offensive Siege of Kut Battle of Luz 1916 Erzurum Offensive Battle of Verdun Lake Narok Offensive Battle of Asiago Battle of Jutland Battle of the Somme Brusilov Offensive Baranovici Offensive Battle of Romani Monastir Offensive Battle of Transylvania 1917 Capture of Baghdad First Battle of Gaza Zimmerman Telegram Second Battle of Aris Kerensky Offensive Third Battle of Ypres Paschendaele Battle of Maricesti Battle of Caporetto Southern Palestine Offensive Battle of Cambrai Armistice of Erzincan 1918 Operation Faustschlag Treaty of Brest-Litovsk Spring Offensive Second Battle of the Marne Battle of Baku Hundred Days Offensive Vardar Offensive Battle of Megiddo Third Transjordan Attack Meuse Argonne Offensive Battle of Vittorio Veneto Battle of Aleppo Armistice of Salonika Armistice of Mudros Armistice of Villa Giusti Armistice with Germany Other Conflicts Mexican Revolution 1910-20 Somaliland Campaign 1910-20 Libyan Resistance Movement 1911-43 Meretz Rebellion 1914-15 Zayan War 1914-21 Indo-German Conspiracy 1914-19. Senussi Campaign 1915-16 Volta Boni War 1915-17 Easter Rising 1916 Anglo-Egyptian Darfur Expedition 1916 Khaosan Revolt 1916-17 Russian Revolution 1917 Finnish Civil War 1918 Post-war conflicts Russian Civil War 1917-21 Ukrainian Soviet War 1917-21 Armenian Azerbaijani War 1918-20 Georgian Armenian War 1918 German Revolution 1918-19 Revolutions and interventions in Hungary 1918-20 Hungarian-Romanian War 1918-19 Greater Poland Uprising 1918-19 Estonian War of Independence 1918-20 Latvian War of Independence 1918-20 Lithuanian Wars of Independence 1918-20 Third Anglo-Afghan War 1919 Egyptian Revolution 1919 Polish-Ukrainian War 1918-19 Polish-Soviet War 1919-21 Irish War of Independence 1919-21 Turkish War of Independence Greco-Turkish War 1919-23 Turkish-Armenian War 1920 Iraqi Revolt 1920 Polish-Lithuanian War 1920 Vlora War 1920 Franco-Syrian War 1920 Soviet Georgian War 1921 Irish Civil War 1922-23 Aspects Opposition Pacifism Anti-war movement deployment Schlieffen Plan German Plan 17 French warfare military engagements naval warfare convoy system air warfare cryptography horse use poison gas railways strategic bombing technology trench warfare total war Christmas truce. Last surviving veterans civilian impact atrocities prisoners casualties economic history 1918 flu pandemic destruction of Kalish rape of Belgium German occupation of Belgium German occupation of Luxembourg German occupation of northeastern France Ober Ost Ottoman people Armenian genocide, Assyrian genocide, Pontic Greek genocide blockade of Germany women Australia popular culture. German prisoners of war in the United States agreements partitioning of the Ottoman Empire Sykes-Picot Agreement Agreement of Saint-Jean-de-Maurienne French-Armenian Agreement Damascus Protocol Paris Peace Conference Venizelos-Titoni Agreement Treaties Treaty of Brest-Litovsk Treaty of Lausanne Treaty of London Treaty of Neuilly Treaty of Saint-Germain Treaty of Sèvres Treaty of Trianon Treaty of Versailles Consequences Aftermath 14 points League of Nations World War I Memorials Centenary Commemorations Category Portal World War I at Wiktionary World War I Textbooks at Wikibooks World War I Quotations at Wikiquote World War I Source Texts at Wikisource World War I Images 9-10th Century Age of Magyars Legend of the White Horse 894 1000-1301 Arpad Dynasty Personal Union of Hungary and Croatia 1102 Hungarian-Byzantine Treaties 1153-1167 Treaty of Pressburg 1271-1302-1526 Middle Ages to Tripartition Treaty of Enns 1336 Hungarian-Lithuanian Treaty 1351 Hungarian-Neapolitan Treaty 1352 Treaty of Zara 1358 Treaty of Lubola 1412 Peace of Szeged 1444 Peace Treaty of Wiener-Neustadt 1463. Treaty of Offaloo 1474 Treaty of Brno 1478 Treaty of Pyotrków 1479 Peace of Olomouc 1479 Treaty of Pressburg 1491 First Congress of Vienna 1515 Dual Reign, Ottoman Vassalship, Reconquest and Napoleonic Wars 1526-1848 Franco-Hungarian Alliance 1526 Treaty of Nagyvarad 1538 Treaty of Gyalu 1541 Confessio Pentapolitana 1549 Treaty of Spire 1570 Treaty of Shitmar 1711-1526-1848 Royal Hungary to Independence Truce of Adrianople 1547 Treaty of Adrianople 1568 Treaty of Vienna 1606 Peace of Zsitvédarok 1606 Peace of Vasvar 1664 Holy League 1684 Treaty of Karlowitz 1699 Treaty of Pasarowitz 1718 Pragmatic Sanction 1723 Treaty of Belgrade 1739 Treaty of Aix-la-Chapelle 1748 First Partition of Poland 1772 Treaty of Sistova 1791 Treaty of Campo Formio 1797 Treaty of Schönbrunn 1809 Congress of Vienna 1815-1570-1711 Principality of Transylvania Peace of Nikolsburg 1621 Treaty of Pressburg 1626 Treaty of Nimwegen 1679 Austria-Hungary to the end of World War I 1848-1922 Austro-Hungarian Compromise of 1867 Croatian-Hungarian Settlement 1868 League of the Three Emperors 1873 Treaty of Bern 1874 Reichstadt Agreement 1876 Budapest Convention of 1877-1877 Treaty of Berlin 1878 Dual Alliance 1879 Triple Alliance 1882 Boxer Protocol 1901 Treaty of London 1913 Armistice of Faxony 1917 Treaty of Brest-Litovsk with Ukraine 1918 Treaty of Brest-Litovsk 1918 Treaty of Bucharest 1918 Armistice of Villa Giusti 1918 Treaty of Trianon 1920 Armistice with Romania 1920 Bill of Dethronement 1921 US-Hungarian Peace Treaty 1921 Covenant of the League of Nations 1922 Modern Age 1922 Treaties of the Kingdom of Hungary 1922-46 Paris Peace Treaties, 1947 Treaties of the Hungarian People's Republic 1949-89 Treaties of the Third Republic of Hungary 1989 VE Treaties of the Ottoman Empire Rise 1299-1453 Venetian Maritime